Okay, so this positive sign. So when Jupiter will be direct position is there, then invention will be very much fruitful. But Saturn is still aspecting it. So when Saturn will become direct, then this Jupiter is in its own sign, and Jupiter is here in Sagittarius up to what sign? When Jupiter will be there, Jupiter will be direct on 14th of September, next month, 14th of September, Jupiter will be direct, means it is not in retrograde, that is more powerful, okay? That is the situation, means discovery or invention of vaccine is possible, but still Saturn is aspecting. When Saturn will be direct? Saturn will be direct on 29th of September, means in the same month, next month, 29th of September, when after 29th of September, you will see that a discovery or invention of vaccine is possible. Reason is, then Jupiter will be very much positive in its own sign, 8th house for India. So Indians can discover this vaccine for this pandemic after 29th of September, because after 29th of September, Saturn will become direct. And no, sorry, this is direct, will be direct till 09, and Jupiter is here in this sign, in the Sagittarius sign, up to November. Jupiter will be here up to, I think, November 20th November. I have written down this Jupiter is here. Okay, so Jupiter will remain in Sagittarius sign up to 20th of November 2020. So up to 20th of November, means before 21st of November, discovery or invention of vaccine is possible. Is 100% possible. I mean, because Venus is going to just shift to the Cancer sign, Jupiter will not, Venus will not oppose this combination. Rahu will shift to this 24th of September next month. Rahu is also shifting to Taurus sign. Rahu will come here in the Taurus sign, in second sign, on 24th of next month, 24th of September. And Venus will shift to this sign. Okay, Venus is still 31st of August, means up to only in the end of this month, 31st of August, Venus is in this Gemini sign. After that, Venus will shift. Rahu Ketu axis is still there. So up to 24th of next month, Rahu Ketu axis will shift to the Lagna ascendant. Then Jupiter is free. Jupiter is in his own sign, positive, okay, in his own sign, but Jupiter will become direct on 14th of September. Only already Jupiter will be direct, but still Rahu Ketu axis is there. Rahu and Ketu will shift to Taurus sign and Scorpio sign, 8th sign in the Lagna, and 7th house Rahu Ketu axis will come. So Jupiter will remain alone, but still Saturn is aspecting. So Saturn will shift, will become direct on 29th of September, means in the next month, ending of that month, means 29th September. Saturn will be direct. After that, Saturn is not aspecting the previous house. Whenever Saturn, any planet is retrograde, is Bakri, is aspecting the previous house. So he is still, Saturn is aspecting Jupiter, is influencing Jupiter, or giving negative aspect to this, or is just neutral. Both are neutral, undoubtedly. They are not influencing so much, but still it is inimical to this one. Means neutral means is not friend, not enemy. But still, aspect, Saturn's aspect on Jupiter is not good. So in this case, Saturn is aspecting, but it is retrograde. When Saturn will be direct, then that aspect on Jupiter will not be there. Then Jupiter is alone, having wisdom, lot of wisdom. It will be very active, and after that, invention is possible. Invention after 29th of September up to November, 20th November, Jupiter is still there in this sign, in his own sign. Sagittarius sign is owned by, this ninth sign is owned by Saturn, Jupiter. Jupiter will be in his own sign and can invent vaccine. Vaccine invention is possible, 100% possible, during this period from September 29 to November 20, 2020. Okay, so November, September, October, November. These 2.5 months or 1.5 months, okay, means mostly two months, 1.5 months, 29th September to means October complete month and 20 days more. So 1.5 months, we may say, okay, 1 month, 20 days. So this is the period in which Jupiter will be alone, in his own sign, will be so much active in the 8th house is for research work. It will do a lot of research. Vaccine is possible in that period. Wearable, this position or Jupiter after this position, I mean, this can happen in other country also. So possibility of invention of this and exit of this possible after that. So, but influence of this whole pandemic will still be remembered by the people. There is no doubt about this. What the best period for this India's horoscope? That I've written down here. What the best period? This is a good period. Good period for India. Moon, Saturn, Moon, Venus, Venus. Venus is Lagna Lord. This period is on 23rd September, means next month, when Rahu Ketu axis will be shifted on 24th next day. So on 23rd to 1st of October, 23rd September to 1st October, means for 8 days, very good period will come, because this period is owned by, I mean, Venus means Moon, Saturn, Moon, again Venus, Venus, this period, and last Venus will be replaced by Sun, etc. But Sun only, Venus then Sun will come. So Sun and Venus will end up to 1st of October. This is the period, 23rd September to 1st of October. This is very good period. In this position, I mean, India will be improved upon all the the treatment of the pandemic. Number of people will be improved upon, my disease will be improved upon. There will be no, still the problem is there, because this is enemical situation with Rahu Ketu. Venus is Rahu. Rahu and Venus friendly, no problem, but Jupiter and Ketu are friend, but they are opposing each other. Means Rahu, Venus and Jupiter, they are enemical to each other, so they are opposing. So still, problem is there. Number of patients is being increased. The reason is this, it is still working upon negatively, right? But positive will be when, after 29th of September, in the next month, when Rahu Ketu axis will be shifted. Before that, 24th of September, after that Rahu Ketu will shift, and 29th of September, Saturn will become direct, it will not influence Jupiter. Jupiter will be alone, Jupiter is already direct on 14th of September. Then the event will improve. What the good days for India? Then Moon, Mercury will start on 19th of April, I think, January, February, March, April, yeah, fourth month, 19th of April, 2021, right? This period will also be auspicious one. Mercury is for fifth lord as well as second lord, so positive and friendly to the Lagna Lord. So because of that, it's positive result. I mean, positive period from 19th April 21 to 19th 04 2023. In between, Ketu's period will also come, but after Mercury, Ketu will come, right? Ketu, then Venus is Lagna Lord. So Moon, Venus period is very auspicious. It will start from 19th 4 2023 to 18th 06 2025. This is very good period for India, right? This good period for India will be utilized, and up to that period, pandemic is, I mean, going to just eliminated after 29th of September. Just imagine that after 29th September, invention of this vaccine is possible, 100% possible, because Jupiter will be in the 8th house in the own sign, and it is just inventing type of planet, wisdom type of planet. So a lot of wisdom will be there in the person who is going to invent the vaccine, right? So this is the period here, right? This I talked about, that here the good period for India's horoscope. This I have taken here, because good period for India's horoscope for India from this Taurus sign I have taken here. So this period is, now Moon period is running up to 25. So during this period up to 25, what are the good periods? So during these good periods, India will improve upon, the fame of India will improve upon. That maybe because of the vaccine invention or something from India. Okay, that is how this whole thing I have discussed about. So India's horoscope is must. We have to, whenever you want to know about the result of that pandemic or any disease or anything, then we have to know that what is the condition of that. Because other countries' horoscopes, I do not know that when those countries' position, but position of the planets we can imagine. If this position of the planet will create havoc or will be very harmful, will be what you call ominous one, very ominous one. Ominous means very, not so much good, is very ominous. Okay, a king will die or a leader, a famous leader will die, this and that. So earthquake will occur, disease, but in this case, disease has happened. The reason is this. Okay, for this malefic position, whenever will occur, right? Mars with Rahu, Saturn with Ketu, and Rahu Ketu axis, Mars and Saturn will come opposite to each other, and this I have observed number of events. Okay, because if I just discuss about number of historical events, for that India's horoscope is to be known. Now Varam here says that India's horoscope is having ascendant Capricorn. Right, before India's independence, India's horoscope was discussed with Capricorn as the ascendant sign, right? Capricorn, 10th sign, which is owned by Saturn. So with the help of that Saturn's ownership of the ascendant lord, ascendant sign, okay, the predictions about India was done by Varamir made this Capricorn as the ascendant of the Indian horoscope. So India was discussed about, predicted about India's events with the help of Capricorn as ascendant sign. Here it is Taurus sign, two number, but before that, independent, India's horoscope are discussed with the help of 10th sign. That is also very important, because all those events, attacks of the invaders like Taimurlung, Mahmud Ghaznavi, all those events, historical events, if I take, it may take a number of days, number of things, that were the situation of the planets in those days. That can also be, we have discussed over this, I mean, number of events, because I remember, I studied Indian history for IAS examination. So for that, in that situation, for 2 or 3 years, I studied Indian history. So I know that what are the events or days, the months in those period, okay, the events occurred, right? Babur's invasion, Panipat, first battle of Panipat. Some say that it was on 14th of January, Makar Sankranti day, okay? As history teachers say. And some say other day. On the particular days, what was the situation of the position of the planets in Indian horoscope, Capricorn as a ascendant, for the position of the planets, we have discussed that also. A lot of things are there. I mean, we can just, you know, imagine that how the situation was there in that locality. We took the Delhi's or Panipat, as the place of birth, if we take Panipat, then what are the horoscope of the country in those days of Northern India. Northern India was mostly influenced by invaders, not South India. South India, West India, no. But only Northern India, Northern place, Delhi including Panipat, Punjab, these areas, up to Himachal Pradesh also, Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, and all these areas, Northern India, Northern India was influenced by invaders mostly. So we have to take Delhi as the center either of the place of birth or Panipat as place of birth, because Battle of Panipat are three. First Panipat, then Babur, after that Hemu, etc., and then Hamasa Abdali. Okay, so all those events we have discussed about. If we have the date of event, and during that period, what the situation of the planet, conjunction of the planet in those days in Indian horoscope, and because of that, these bad events occurred. Okay, or massacre of the people occurred. People were killed, and what the situation of the World War First, World War Second, World War First. During 1914 to 1918, World War First started. So during that period, in the beginning, okay, because whenever the beginning starts, a battle occurs or war occurs, in that situation, the condition of the planets, force the people to involve in that kind of situation or that kind of things, right? So war also, whenever, international wars or world war, that no World War. World War First, World War Second, 1939 to 1945. So 1939 to 1945, what the situation of the planet in those days, and what the position of the condition of the position planets in the horoscope of India or horoscope of other countries, because India was also involved in, Indian people were involved in World War First, World War Second also, because Britishers were ruling in those days, and they took number of Indians killed during this period, because they wanted that British will leave India. So because of that, we have to, because leaders of those days, they asked the people that help Britishers to fight against other countries, okay, involved in World War First and World War II.